Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel Gyan Sampada. From some of our previous classes, we are dealing with different techniques to determine the thickness of any given thin film. And today, let us study a very important and significant method of thickness determination, which is nothing but vibrating quartz method. So if you look at the name of the method, then we can say that there is a quartz crystal which is involved. It is also vibrating, and roughly we can say that the vibrations of the quartz crystal in the setup is going to help us in determination of thickness of a thin film. So let us study in detail what is the significance of this method, what is the working and what are the different components of the setup. So this vibrating quartz method is a very useful gravimetric technique to measure both deposition rate as well as the film thickness. And also it involves quartz crystal oscillator. So gravimetric means relating to the measurement of weight. So with respect to change in weight or mass, how the quartz crystal vibrations are linked, let us check it out. So as I told, this is a gravimetric technique which is very significant. The quartz crystal microbalance which is used in this method is an extremely sensitive mass balance which is going to measure nanogram to microgram level changes in mass per unit area. So we can understand a minute change in the mass is going to be recorded here. So as it involves a quartz crystal oscillator, it is based on using the thickness shear mode of piezoelectric quartz crystal. We know quartz is a kind of a material which is said to be piezoelectric. Piezoelectric consists of two words or two terms. Piezo, which is originated actually from a Greek word piezin, which means to press. And in short, we can just remember that piezoelectric means when pressure is applied, electricity will be produced, which can be easily detected. So a small amount of pressure or deformation or any mechanical stress is going to give us electric response out of it. So this is the basis of this method. Main thing is the quartz crystal, which is piezoelectric in nature. But how to measure thickness is the question. So the measured change in resonant frequency of the quartz oscillator during the deposition is going to vary linearly with respect to mass which is deposited on the crystal electrode. So you will get a very clear picture when you understand it with respect to the block diagram. Now we need to remember that as deposition is going on taking place, the mass is going to vary, and as the mass varies, the resonant frequency of the quartz oscillator is going to vary because there will be a kind of a stress which will be acting on the quartz crystal. So if a crystal sensor is placed near the substrate during the deposition, then the coating on the crystal increases its mass, and that's why it is going to lower the resonant frequency because both are inversely proportional. And these are some of the main things which we need to remember when we are going to understand about vibrating quartz method. So let's get into detail and let's understand it more properly by knowing the system. So we call it as quartz crystal microbalance, or in short QCM, or the film thickness monitoring system. And it is comprised mainly of three components. First one is the quartz crystal sensor, which is the main part. Then the second one is the temperature controlled housing or the sensor head. So that can be understood in this diagram. This is showing the quartz crystal sensor, which is the main part of the quartz crystal microbalance. So this is the quartz crystal, and in between there is a electrode which are acting as a contacts. And this is an in vacuum cable to maintain a proper environment. So these are the two components, and the third one is the most important to monitor the thickness, that is the electronic monitor or controller. So in short, let us see what is the functioning of this controller. So this controller forces the crystal into vibration, that is quartz crystal starts vibrating, and also this is going to monitor or track the frequency of the vibration with respect to time. So stimulus is given, it may be a small voltage which will make the quartz crystal vibrate, and simultaneously it will be monitored and the frequency will be recorded with respect to different times. And an internal microprocessor then is going to convert this frequency into the actual thickness of the film. So that finally, by knowing the frequency, we are going to find out what is the thickness of the film using some formula or the software. So this is, in short, what are the main components. One is the quartz crystal sensor, second one is the sensor head, and third one is the controller or the monitor. So let's check it out where the components are placed in the setup. So if you observe the block diagram, here we are having a quartz sensor, that is nothing but QCM, quartz crystal sensor, which is connected with the in vacuum cable with a feed through. Then this is the source, which we need to deposit a thin film over the substrate, and this is a source shutter for controlling the evaporation or supply of the source onto the substrate. Then this is connected to an external monitor or controller, which will be having its own software to convert the frequency of vibration with respect to the quartz crystal into the corresponding thickness of the thin film based on the deposition. So this is a rough idea of the block diagram and the working. So here the components which we have already seen, some are within the vacuum chamber and some are partially outside. Those components which are within the vacuum chamber are termed as in vacuum components, and in the thickness monitoring system, the in vacuum components are the quartz crystal itself, the sensor head with the electrical connections, water lines, thermocouple, as well as heating elements, and also the feed through, which is going to connect the internal components with the air side, that is the outside component. So we can observe whatever is seen here, that is starting from the quartz sensor to the feed through, it is in vacuum component. So it has to be maintained under vacuum. Then coming to the external components of the thickness monitoring system, so the cables and the fittings from the feed through, which we can observe here, the BNC cable connecting to the oscillator, and this oscillator makes the crystal vibrate and also measures the vibrations continuously. That is the work of the oscillator, and it is outside the vacuum chamber. And also the monitor or controller, which displays and acts upon the information, processes it, and finally gives the thickness as well as the deposition rate, is also outside. So generally it is done using high-end PCs using certain softwares. So this is a complete explanation of the components and how they are going to be fitted within the instrument. And the main part is to understand the working of the quartz crystal microbalance. So how it is going to work is the main question. So first is the principle, and the principle is the piezoelectric effect. The quartz crystal monitor operates on this principle. Already we know piezoelectric effect is nothing but the effect where electricity will be generated on application of pressure or any given stress. When a free running RF voltage is applied to the quartz crystal, it vibrates at its natural frequency, that is obvious because of the vibrations. So this quartz disc is the heart of the technology. So the quartz crystal, which is a piezoelectric material that can be made to oscillate using the oscillator, that can be made to oscillate at a defined frequency by applying appropriate voltage, which are usually given via the metal electrodes which we observe in the quartz sensor. Then at a constant temperature, this frequency is going to remain constant, that is stable, until and unless the crystal's mass changes. If the crystal's mass is going to change, then the frequency is going to change. So the frequency of oscillation can be affected by the addition or removal of small amounts of mass onto the electrode surface. And depositing the thin film on the crystal surface will change the mass of the crystal, and thus the increase in the mass from the deposition causes the resonant frequency of the crystal to lower. and such changes are easily detected electronically and converted into thickness measurements, as the frequency can be monitored in real time to obtain useful information about the molecular interactions or reactions taking place at the electrode surface, such as film growth, the oxidation, corrosion, decay, etc. And by electronically measuring at short intervals, the rate of the deposition also can be computed. So this is the main use of this method, where we can find out the deposition rate as well as the thickness of the thin film which is deposited. And that's why, due to the simultaneous measurement of the deposition rate as well as thickness, and that's why, as the measurements are very quick due to the advancement of technology, we can obtain any film of any given thickness as it is simultaneously monitored using the controller. And also the deposition rate can be adjusted. And it has been determined that it is more accurate to monitor the crystal's changing period than its changing frequency. Period means nothing but time per vibration. That is more useful when compared to measuring the frequency, that is the vibrations per second. Today's digital circuitry makes it very easy for modern crystal monitors to use the crystal's changing period as the basis for the thickness measurements. Since heat also changes the frequency of vibration of the crystal, the monitor must be water cooled to provide accurate readings. So for almost 60 years, quartz crystal microbalance has been used under vacuum and also under gas phase. And about 40 years ago, this technique was also shown to be applicable in liquid medium. And if you go on studying about quartz crystal microbalance or the vibrating quartz method, it is a very huge concept, and I have covered main highlights of the method. I hope it will be useful for you. Study well, practice more, stay safe, and thank you for watching.